हेलो दोस्तों, अंडरस्टैंडिंग पॉलिटिकल थ्योरी की नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन की वीडियो भी आ गई है, तो सभी असाइनमेंट्स की वीडियोस भी जल्दी ही अपलोड कर दी जाएगी। वीडियोस के अपलोड होते ही नोटिफिकेशन के लिए हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को प्रेस करें। वीडियो को लाइक और शेयर करना भी नहीं भूलना। अब आते हैं क्वेश्चन पे। तो लास्ट वीडियो में हमने क्वेश्चन लिया था क्रिटिकली एनालाइज द फेमिनिज्म पॉलिटिकल थ्योरी। अब हम क्वेश्चन ले रहे हैं डेमोक्रेसी के ऊपर। सो द क्वेश्चन इज, डिस्कस द ओरिजिन एंड एवोल्यूशन ऑफ द आइडिया ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। आंसर, डेमोक्रेसी इज डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम टू ग्रीक वर्ड्स, डेमोस मीनिंग पीपल एंड क्रेटोस मीनिंग रूल और पावर। इट इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन विच द पीपल हैव द अथॉरिटी टू चूज देयर गवर्निंग लेजिस्लेशन। हु पीपल आर एंड हाउ अथॉरिटी इज शेयर्ड अमंग देम आर कोर इशूज फॉर डेमोक्रेटिक थ्योरी डेवलपमेंट एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। सम कॉर्नर स्टोन्स ऑफ दीज इशूज आर फ्रीडम ऑफ असेंबली एंड स्पीच, इंक्लूसिवनेस एंड इक्वालिटी, मेंबरशिप, कंसेंट, वोटिंग, राइट टू लाइफ एंड माइनॉरिटी राइट्स। देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एंड डायरेक्ट। रिप्रेजेंटेटिव डेमोक्रेसी, इन इट द पावर इज इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स हु आर इलेक्टेड बाय द पीपल। पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज आर ऑफन सेंट्रल टू दिस फॉर्म ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी बिकॉज इलेक्टोरल सिस्टम्स रिक्वायर वोटर्स टू वोट फॉर पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज एज अपोज टू इंडिविजुअल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स। डायरेक्ट डेमोक्रेसी, इट इज़ अ प्योर फॉर्म ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन विच ऑल पीपल मेक डिसीजंस विदाउट इंटरमीडिएट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स। द एवोल्यूशन ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी फ्रॉम एंशियंट टू द मॉडर्न टाइम्स। फर्स्ट इज द टर्म डेमोक्रेसी फर्स्ट अपियर्ड इन एंशियंट ग्रीक पॉलिटिकल एंड फिलोसॉफिकल थॉट। द ग्रीक सिटी स्टेट्स ऑफ एथेंस लेड बाय क्लिस्थिनस एस्टेब्लिश्ड व्हाट इज जनरली हेल्ड एज द फर्स्ट डेमोक्रेसी इन 507 BCE. Clisthenes is referred to as the father of Athenian democracy. An Athenian philosopher Plato contrasted democracy, the system of rule by the governed, with the alternative systems of monarchy, meaning rule by one individual, oligarchy, meaning rule by small elite class, and democracy, meaning ruling class of property owners. Today, classical Athenian democracy is considered by many to have been a direct democracy. Originally, it had two distinguishing features. First, the allotment of ordinary citizens to the few government offices and the courts, and secondarily, the assembly of all the citizens. All citizens were eligible to speak and vote in the assembly, which set the laws of the city-state. However, Athenian citizens were all male, born from parents who were born in Athens and excluded women, slaves, foreigners, and males under 20 years old. Even though the Roman Republic contributed significantly to certain aspects of democracy, only a minority of Romans were citizens with votes in elections for representatives. The votes of the powerful were given more weight through a system of gerrymandering, so most high officials, including members of the Senate, came from a few wealthy and noble families. However, many notable exceptions did occur. Second is Middle Ages. During the Middle Ages, there were various systems involving elections or assemblies. Although often only involving a small amount of the population, the election of Gopala in Bengal, the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, the Althing in Iceland, the Lochting in Faroe Islands, certain medieval Italian city-states such as Venice, the Tuatha system in early medieval Ireland, and the autonomous merchant city in Sakai in the 16th century in Japan. However, participation was often restricted to minority, so may be better classified as oligarchy. Most regions in medieval Europe were ruled by clergy or feudal lords. Third is 18th and 19th centuries. The first nation is in modern history to adopt a democratic constitution was the short-lived Corsican Republic in 1755. This Corsican constitution was the first based on Enlightenment principles and even allowed for female suffrage, something that was granted in other democracies only by the 20th century, although not described as a democracy by the founding fathers. The United States founders also shared a determination to root the American experiment in the principle of natural freedom and equality. The United States Constitution, adopted in 1788, provided for an elected government and protected civil rights and liberties for some. During the 1820s and 1830s, the American Colonization Society was the primary vehicle for proposals to return black Americans to freedom in Africa. In the 1860s United States Census, the slave population in the United States had grown to 4 million, and after the Civil War, the newly freed slaves became citizens with a nominal right to vote, but only men, not women. Fourth is 20th and 21st centuries. In the 1920s, democracy flourished, but the Great Depression brought disenchantment, and most of the countries of Europe, Latin America, and Asia turned to strongman rule or dictatorships. Fascism and dictatorships flourished in Nazi Germany, Italy, Spain, and Portugal, as well as the non-democratic regimes in the Baltics, the Balkans, Brazil, Cuba, China, and Japan, among others. World War II brought a definitive reversal of this trend in Western Europe. The successful democratization of the American, British, and French sectors of occupied Germany, disputed Austria, Italy, and the occupied Japan serves as a model for the later theory of regime change. By the 1960s, the vast majority of country states were nominally democracies. Although the majority of the world's populations lived in nations that experienced sham elections and other forms of subterfuge, particularly in communist nations and the former colonies. यहाँ पे हमारा understanding political theory का assignment complete होता है, या answer complete होता है. और याद रखना, हर पेज के नीचे आपको सिग्नेचर करना है, पेज नंबर डालना है, और सभी पेजेस के ऊपर एसएल रोल नंबर, एग्ज़ाम रोल नंबर और नेम ज़रूर लिखना है, भूलना मत. एंड बाकी अभी जल्दी और भी असाइनमेंट्स की वीडियो अपलोड हो जाएगी, तो प्लीज़ लाइक करें, शेयर करें, सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को प्रेस करना ना भूलें.